Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this course Certification in Quantity Surveying, and we are looking into what are the provisions that are provided by the IS code 1200 related to the concreting. That is our topic today. We'll be looking into the part 2 of IS 1200. So there are proper mentioning about the every clause had some meaning. So let's start with the first one. What are the stages of the measurement? They have given it two stages, that is a below ground level and above ground level. As the rates for the concreting are different for both of these levels, so the bifurcation is given into the above and below ground levels. Then what are the types of concrete they have covered into this one? It is a PCC, that's a plain cement concrete, RCC, reinforced cement concrete, and the precast or pre-stressed concrete also is covered into this one. So whatever the clauses are related to this IS code will be applicable to this PCC, RCC, and precast itself. Then I have taken out this screenshot of the IS code. Sorry for this blur image, because the code available with me had the same blur image. So I'll go with this one. So we are talking about the deductions now, and where you are not expected to do the deduction, that is our first clause. So whenever there are the ends of dissimilar material overlapping on each other, like beams, posts, girders, rafters, purlin, trusses, whose area in cross section is not more than 500 centimeter square, whose area is not more than 500 centimeter square, you are not expected to do any deduction for concreting. Then the opening in a concreting, its area not more than 0.1 meter square, you are not expected to deduct any quantity. Then the volumes that has been occupied by reinforcement is not to be deducted at all. Then the volume occupied by pipes, conduits, not exceeding 100 centimeter square in cross sections, you are not expected to do any deduction for the same. Then the next one, which are the small voids whose area is not exceeding 40 centimeter square, is not to be taken out from the concreting. And these are some of the images relating to this one. So these are the hatch area provided. If the area is not more than 40 centimeter square, you are not expected to take out any quantity or deduct any quantity from the concreting this member. Then there are some other details related to the how you define the beam length and the column length, how you exactly come to know that from where to where I have to measure the column and from where to where the beam starts and ends. So this is about this one. This clause 4.2.2 illustrates about the same. The first one, the columns shall be measured from the top of the column base to the underside of the first floor slab, and subsequently from the top of the first floor slab to the next floor slab. So if I want to illustrate this one, this is called as a column neck. So if I want to measure the column length from the first, then I have to go from the top of the foundation or where the column starts till the bottom of the slab, then from the next one, top of this slab to the bottom of the next slab. So whatever this length that we are going to have will be the length for the column, those respective columns. Next one, in case of columns for flat slabs, flare of the column shall be included with the column measurement. Now, so what are the flat slabs? We know flat slabs are those where we don't have any beams, and so we have to give some supports with the help of column itself. So these are some of the support. If these supports are given, or suppose this additional flares are provided, so whatever the concreting that has been in going to get induced into this one will include it into the measurement of the column itself. Then the beams shall be measured from the face to face of the columns, and shall include haunches if any in between the columns and the beams. So that means, so the beams, they are to be measured from the face of this column to the face of this column. Whatever the clear span we are going to have will be the length of the beam. Or support, if there are any flanges given, any supports given, they should be also included into the beams as mentioned in this clause. Then the depth of the beam shall be measured from the bottom of the slab to the bottom of the beam, and in an inverted case vice versa. So that means if I want to measure the depth of the beam, I'll be measuring from bottom of the slab to the bottom of the beam. This will be the depth of the beam in this case. And in this case, the top of the slab to the top of the beam. This will be length measurement in this case. Next one, concreting in chajjas. This is very essential one, and this is what most of the times people do ask whenever they are conducting any interviews or anything. because judges are kind of critical when they don't consume much quantity, but they tell you whether you have a sound knowledge of the subject or not. So concreting in chajjas, when chajja is combined with a beam on a lintel, that is important. So it is a lintel, part of a lintel beam, the common portion shall be measured at chajja. So that means, let's go for part one over here. So when the chajja, this is support, if it is a lintel beam and the chajja is a part of the lintel beam, then only this common portion can be considered as the length of the chajja. Only this common portion is considered to be length of the chajja, and it has been taken into the concreting calculations. Okay, let's go for second part. Then when the chajja is in continuation of a roof or a suspended slab, it shall be measured up to the center line of a bearing. Now I'll segregate it into the small parts. When chajja is in continuation of a roof or suspended slab, so that means if the chajja is in continuation, so if suppose this is a roof slab and it's a continuation of this one, so we can call it a small gallery. We do have taken out some take a sit out or anything. So if for that we are talking about, so if it is a part of a roof slab, if the chajja is a part of the roof slab, then it shall be measured up to the center line of bearing. So now what that has to say, it shall be measured from the center line of bearing means what? Center line of bearing is a column center line. In this case, we are talking about the center line of the column. So if I want to take out the quantity of this chajja, then I have to measure this much of quantity till the center line of the column. So this whole quantity is to be considered under the concreting in a chajja. Then this will be the part of a slab, and whatever the beam is there, this will be the quantity of a beam. So these three different parts will be, this concreting will be divided into three different parts. Up to the half of the bearing of the this column's bearing, the concreting will go under the chajja. Other half will be the part of this slab itself, and whatever the beam depth is left, that will be part of a beam only. So these are very minute clues that you should know and remember whenever we are going to calculate any concreting quantity related to the chajja, beam, slabs and anything. So we'll be seeing them in a detail while calculating the quantities. With this, I wish you all the best. Thank you so much.